There's always time for personal hygiene.
Oh, I actually don't know about that.
They say that we're all messed up and
I don't know why that was a singing style when we were in school.
Hey there, Delilah, what's it like in New York City? I'm 1,000 miles away, but girl, tonight you look so pretty. Yes, you do.
Dark, work and shine and surprise you.
I swear it's true.
What a song.
Yes, it is. Oh, I get asked this very often. It is an avocado, not an egg. It's an avocado.
Thank you.
That's all you wanted to know?
All I wanted to, I've been staring at it this whole time.
Right there. Pin included. Look at that, it's right there.
Anybody no, you don't have the pin. Doesn't Steph have the pin?
Why everybody wants to know why?
My fiance and I, Stephanie, we got matching avocado tattoos when we got engaged. Hers actually has the pin. Mine isn't colored in. But she has the pit and the other side of the avocado. And so
is this like a relationship inside joke, avocado something?
No, we just wanted to get one together and so we're like, let's get an avocado.
Well,
thanks. Oh! That's down. I'm stealing that.
Okay.
I totally have seen your double in life.
My double?
Oh, really?
Yeah. Oh, no.
We got the four guys here, and how is it steering a tour bus between the four of you?
Stinky.
It is a lot of smells going on.
The smell of animosity.
And just when you think it's four, it's actually, what is it, 11, 12?
11. There's actually 11 people on the tour bus with, like, you know, our crew, and then we've got, you know, the whole kit and caboodle.
Today is National Spouses Day, and I know you guys aren't technically spouses, but
really?
You spend so much time together. Do you get on each other's nerves?
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely.
Most definitely, yeah. You really learn the value of personal space when you're on the road for this length of time.
Is there one person who's a bigger culprit than the rest?
Probably Bobby.
Of course, yeah.
We all have our moments.
Just throwing Bobby under the bus. I love it.
Literally.
Now, this is your guys' kind of first headlining tour that you're doing. And I remember last time I saw you guys was at Dolphins Country Fest. And
yep.
You guys are coming back to do Dolphin again, this time going to be playing the main stage. How exciting is that for you guys?
We are super pumped. We actually ran out of gas last time we played Dolphin, so hopefully that's not going to happen this time. But
Not metaphorically.
The vehicle
ran out of fuel.
I had to run for like 5 clicks and hitchhike in a trucker and brought a jerry can.
So we're not going to talk about that.
We're pumped to be playing the main stage because we got to see the setup last year. We were up on the hill last year. But like just that setup with those stands is going to be like the most epic thing, I think.
Is this kind of the goal, so to speak? Do you know, last year you guys were playing the hill, now you're playing the main stage. What are some of the goals for the James Barker Band moving forward here?
It's just kind of to keep growing and keep making music that our fans enjoy listening to. Like, we love making music, we love playing shows, and so as long as we're still able to do that and have people sitting there listening to us, we're happy. And, you know, this over the course of the last, like, 6 months, we've made a really heavy push into the States. And so that's obviously a big mountain we're climbing right now, too.
Yeah.
It's definitely been a kind of a meteoric rise for you guys in that, you know, every single you guys have dropped has been so successful. And it wasn't that long ago that you guys were, you know, in the contest at Boots and Hearts trying to, you know, to make it.
I got a good old Facebook memory as of 2 days ago or 3 days ago. And it was a picture of us in Nashville just like
I forget we were at some restaurant or whatever, and it's like, yeah, 2 years ago, as of basically today or yesterday, we hadn't even released Lawn Chair, hadn't released anything whatsoever. We were still playing like the small bar circuit and stuff in Ontario, and to, you know, to kind of step back and see where we are 2 years later is like unbelievably humbling too. It's amazing.
What do you give the credit to for, you know, how big it's gotten so fast?
Myself.
Honestly, we are super blessed to have like the most amazing, like intense fans in the world. Yeah. Like they are all over that social media game nonstop. They're all over Twitter, they're all over Instagram and Facebook, and they have supported us right out of the get-go. From when we were playing bars, you know, the people started coming out, to right up until, you know, this tour, going across the country and playing it. We have people who just like are diehards, and you know, those people have literally made our career for us.
Hey guys, thanks so much for watching, and to see more videos like what you just watched, all you have to do is subscribe to our channel by clicking the button below.
Hey guys.
Thanks.